The Texans first down.
And Stover proved his toughness in his time at Ohio State, played on offense at tight end and fullback, also played a little defense as a linebacker. Strong hands, can catch the football. Remember the story about massaging bowls in order to increase the hand strength.
Now Stroud, and incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
Inside handoff to Mixon, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Oftentimes, when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. From the gun on third down, here's Stroud. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 31-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, on third down, he wanted to go to one of his most dependable targets, and that's who he found, his tight end there, to pick up the first, Charles.
And you use the proper word there, dependable, and sometimes spectacular, because tight ends nowadays, they can do it all. But they're the guys you trust, especially across the middle of the field where there's traffic. He delivers, and they pick up nice yardage.
Man open downfield is Diggs. He's got it. Touchdown, Houston. Stephon Diggs, 31 yards. And the Texans get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Well, Charles, here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. That looked like a well-designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon. A player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
Fairbairn good with the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. That time a six-play drive. And it's finished off by the touchdown by Stephon Diggs. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. So here come the Jaguars to take over for the first time behind Trevor Lawrence, their quarterback in season number 4.
Last year was a bit of a mixed bag for Lawrence as he started off looking like a budding superstar, but then he suffered an ankle injury and was a shell of himself the rest of the way. His team needs him to stay healthy if they plan on maximizing their full potential. And if that ends up being the case, they'll have a good shot to win a lot of games here in 2024.
Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10 at their own 27. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's caught. It's the former Bill, Gabe Davis. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 48-yard line. A give to Etienne running right. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they will pay dividends as the game progresses.
Ball on the 27. Here's second and a yard. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Another tote for Etienne. Azeez Al-Shaair in to make the stop.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Second and six. Now whistles here, and I believe one of the Jaguar linemen might have moved. Well, the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. From the gun, it's Lawrence. And his pass incomplete.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Lawrence to throw. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down.
Like any team playing, they're looking for touchdowns to try and help their cause. But in this case, he does get them a little closer at least if they think a field goal turns out to be the better call here.
Now a field goal try coming up here for the Jags. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Stroud working out of the gun. That one complete. It's Tank Dell. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And that's going to bring up second down. Stroud to throw it. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 30. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
2 yards on the pickup there, and it's second down. Again, it's Drown. Another one caught by Collins. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 17-yard line. Now after the play, it looks like there's a Texan here slow to get up. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Inside handoff to Mixon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He was brought down by Foya Sade Aluakin. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
As Stroud now to throw. And that's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. A line of scrimmage once again, the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. Here's Stroud.
Touchdown, Texans!
Stephon Diggs. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Texans are able to stretch out their lead. Still first quarter, 2 receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to him. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area wherever he lines up to at least try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbear. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it's finished off by the touchdown by Stephon Diggs. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbear now to kick it away. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. So time to see Jacksonville again on offense for the second time here in this game. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down.
I certainly like what he did right there because he smartly wanted to avoid forcing anything downfield because nothing appeared to be open. Nice harmless slide there to avoid the big hit, and he gets a small gain on the play.
Here's Lawrence. He'll get this into the hands of the wideout from LSU. And he is going to have a Jags first down. They needed three. He doubled that. He got six. Pretty good location there on that throw.
It really was, wasn't it? That was likely one where the receiver was either going to catch it or no one. Really good decision. And boy, what a catch and move right there.
And a tough spot to get it over the middle. On first and 10, it's ETN. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Now a second and 10. Lawrence. A short throw to Ingram. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And this will wind up being a third and three.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred the defense. Now, that was a big-time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let him get anywhere near it.
So on fourth down, here's Logan Cook to punt for Jacksonville. Back deep is Steven Sims. And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty. After one, a 14-3 ball game. Ready for the second quarter from Houston. It's the Texans in possession of the football as they get set to start their drive with a first and 10. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3-for-3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it, and afterwards they'll say, there is never a doubt in our minds. That's so true, and it certainly felt like NFL football at its finest, right? You talk about the highest level for both of these offenses. Neither one of them afraid of taking risks, and both of them aggressively pushing it downfield. I did like, Brandon, how smart they were about going about their business, though. They were high-flying, but they took care of the ball.
Yeah, they did. And just keeping it clean in a game like this with all these points, you don't see that very often, even at the highest level. Job well done.